Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of 13 Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 13 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. I'm Jeff Knight, and in this episode, I'm going to be talking to you about how to control the color of your text. Now, you may be thinking, Jeff, this is some very basic After Effects 101 level stuff. But I can assure you, there's a lot more to choosing how you control the color of your text than you might think. There are times when you want to specifically use the color control panel, or fills, or layer styles, or text animators. Now, all of these methods have their own strengths and weaknesses, but there is one that is the most versatile, gives you the most amount of control, and can be used in literally any situation. I guarantee you will learn something from this tutorial. Now, I'm gonna start ramping up the number of videos I'll be making for this channel. So please like, share, and subscribe. Have your friends and colleagues like, share, and subscribe. Let's get as many subscribers as we possibly can for this channel. And as always, don't forget to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so the first method we're going to take a look at for controlling your text color is the character panel color control. So the way this works is After Effects will apply whatever fill color, stroke color, and stroke width that you use last to a new text layer. As you can see, this is our character panel color control. We have access to fills and to strokes, and also to a stroke width, and we have the setting for fill over stroke and stroke over fill. Well, let's just go ahead and add a stroke. I'm going to just make it red, and then let's get rid of our fill color here. Get rid of this text and then say I want to start to type something else. And as you can see, it brought on the last settings we used, which was just this stroke setting right here. Keep that in mind whenever you add text, it's going to apply the settings that you used on your previous text layer. Applying color through the character panel color control is good for adding a fill or a stroke that doesn't need to be animated. You can change the fill and stroke of specific words or text. So say, for example, what if I wanted character to have a different color than the rest of the text? We can just highlight character and then we can change the color of that. And so now that has its own color. We can even add a stroke just for that one word. And then we have the stroke over fill or fill over stroke setting. We can adjust that. So you can control characters or words or even lines with the character panel color control. The only thing you can't do is you can't animate it. So whatever settings you apply, you're stuck with. So that's one of the limitations of it. That's a weakness it has. The strength that it does have is that you do have full control over changing the colors of characters or words. Okay, so the next method we're going to take a look at is layer style color control. If we highlight this layer and we go up to layer, we see under layer styles, the options you want to choose are color overlay, which is another word for fill, and stroke. So go ahead and add a color overlay, and we're going to add a stroke. And the way this works is it applies the last colors that you used with your layer styles. So obviously I used a blue for my color overlay and a green for my stroke. Okay, so controlling the color of your text using layer styles is good whenever you need to animate the color of your text. As you see right here, we have stopwatches, which means these can be animated. So say we'll start with our color overlay. If I set a keyframe for color and go forward, I can change that to a different color. And we can either make these keyframes linear. We can also make them easy ease, where it kind of eases into one or the other. Or you can toggle to a hold keyframe and it will pop on the color once your marker gets to that keyframe. So you do have control over how the color is animated, which is something you did not have with the character panel color control. The thing that you don't have control over is you cannot change individual characters or words. Highlight just the word layer right here, change the color. Notice it applies the color to the entire layer. So you cannot change the colors of individual words, characters, or individual lines. So it's something that you definitely want to keep in mind. And then right here, you have this opacity setting. And this opacity setting is going to affect the color only. So see, as we come down to zero, the color that we see is white, and that's whatever color you have in your character panel color control right here. So say if we changed our original color to red, when this is set to zero, our text is going to be red. So this opacity setting only affects the color of the color overlay. One of the other options we have here is we have this blend mode, and this doesn't really do a whole lot. It kind of tweaks some of the settings depending on what color mode that you use. It's really effective, however, if you add something like a gradient overlay layer style. I'm going to set my color overlay to an overlay setting. So see, you can get some interesting looks if you have a gradient overlay or maybe a texture on your text. But if it's just a solid color, you're really more limited with what these settings are going to do. So let's move down to our stroke setting here. Again, we have the blend mode. We have the color option. We can change this to whatever color we want. This is keyframeable, and we can adjust the size of our stroke width here. And then again, we have this opacity, which again only affects the stroke of this layer style. And then we have this setting called position. And think about this very similar to the way our character panel fill over stroke and stroke over fill is. So this is our center setting. If we go to inside, this is more kind of like a stroke over fill. And then we set it to outside, it's more of like a fill over stroke. And then our center would be somewhere in between. So the look that you're going for will dictate what you want your position set to. One of the things to take note of is that your character panel fill over stroke or stroke over fill does not affect your layer whenever you're using layer styles. Again, that's going to be controlled through this position, but just notice that no matter what this is set to, it's not going to affect it. The thing that will affect it is your stroke width settings. And the way this kind of interacts with layer styles isn't completely straightforward. So I would recommend just setting your stroke width and then adjusting your stroke width through your layer style right here. And notice also that it's not necessary for you to have a stroke enabled in order to use a layer style stroke. However, you do have to have a fill enabled. See, if I take off this fill, now this color overlay has zero effect whatsoever. So you have to have a fill enabled in order to use the color overlay. You do not have to have a stroke enabled. Think of the stroke through the layer style as just an extra stroke, because you can actually have a stroke on here and say, we'll take off the color overlay. And now this is being controlled by our color control panel. So let's make this something that kind of stands out. We'll make the stroke red. And so if we increase it, we can see we actually have a red stroke. And we also have this additional blue stroke. For the most straightforward results, I would just use the layer style color overlay and stroke if you're going to use that, unless you want to do something like blend your color. So see, as I adjust this opacity on my color overlay, it's mixing this blue color overlay with our orange character. Again, one of the things that you cannot do is you cannot animate the color of individual characters or words. So that can be a disadvantage depending on what you're going for. Okay, so the next method is a fill control color. So if we highlight this text layer here, we go to Effect, Generate, and Add a Fill. And so this fill is going to affect the entire text layer. Again, you cannot add a fill to just individual characters or words. So say if I highlight color, I want to make that its own color. Come here and add yellow. It's just going to apply it to the entire text layer. Also, if I add in a stroke, you have no access to a stroke. Think about a fill as just adding a color to everything. So it's adding this yellow color to both the fill and the stroke. So you can't even see the stroke. So that's one of the disadvantages. If you add a fill, you have no access to a stroke anymore. And now there are a few other settings we have under our fill. We have this invert. If you click on that, it's going to apply the fill to your background and then apply the background color to your text. And then unlike layer style opacity, remember when we're over here in our layer styles, if we adjusted this opacity, it just took off the color of this color overlay. With a fill, this opacity applies to the layer itself. So as we reduce the opacity, notice our text goes away. So it's not like a blending kind of opacity, it's the opacity of the entire layer. One of the things to keep in mind too, is if we add a layer style, say we'll add a color overlay with a fill, the layer style will always override the fill. So see, the only color we're seeing is from our layer style here. But if we reduce the color overlay opacity, it's going to interact with our fill color up here. But if both of these are set to 100%, then the layer style will always override it. If we reduce our fill opacity, it still has control over the entire text layer. These two methods, using a fill and a layer style, does not allow you to control the color of individual characters, words, or lines. Whenever you add a layer style or a fill, it's going to apply that color to the entire text layer. Okay, and so our last method here, which is the most versatile, is going to be the text animator color control. If we open up our text layer right here, we go to animate. So notice for fill color, we have RGB, hue, saturation, brightness, and opacacity. We're going to focus on RGB. And then we also have stroke color, same settings, but we're going to use RGB, and we have stroke width. So there are a few things you need to know whenever you're adding in fill color and a stroke color from a text animator. First, let's go ahead and add in our fill color RGB. And then I like to rename my animator. So we're going to just call this fill. Make sure you highlight text if you're going to add in a stroke. So we'll add in RGB. And we have this other animator here for stroke. You have all these settings under your range selector that we're about to go over. Under our advanced tab, we have a lot of settings, and they allow you to control how the color is displayed on your text. If we take away this stroke and say we highlight fill, if you had a stroke here, this is going to be controlled by the same settings. So see, we may want to control certain things using this in percentage. Well, now our fill and stroke are both being controlled by one set of variables. So you don't really want to do that. Instead, we're going to go to text and we're going to add a stroke color RGB, call this stroke. So that way these can be controlled independently. But within that stroke, we do want to add in a stroke width. Okay, now one of the things to take note of is that these both default to red. Go ahead and change this color right here. And as you notice, we don't have a stroke color right here. If we increase our stroke, we see nothing happens. And the reason why is because for this layer of text, we don't have a stroke enabled. So in order to have a text animator stroke, you have to enable the stroke from your character control panel. So just add any color, and I would set this to 0, and I'll show you why in just a second. Now you can control the stroke width through your text animator. The fill over stroke and stroke over fill settings from the character control panel directly affects the look of our text. Also notice that if we remove our fill, our text animator fill disappears. This is because there's nothing for the text animator to lay its color over. So you have to have both fill and stroke enabled with some value in the character control panel in order to affect the text through text animators. So I'm just going to reset some of these values, and then let's focus on our text animator fill and go through some of these settings. If we open up our range selector, we have these percentages. It defaults to end at 100%. So that's going to be the end of this color. And start percentage is 0. That's the beginning of this color. Now watch as I start to come back. We can control by character what is going to be colored differently. And the other color that it's pulling from is this character panel here. So say if I make that, we'll make it like an orange. These percentages are applying this fill color. So at 0% on start and 100% on end, it's covering the entire text layer. But you can adjust this by character. If you come down here to based on, go to word, and it will skip through the next word. And notice how we have this fading here. So see how this color is kind of in between. To get rid of that, come down to your ease high, make that 100%, and ease low, make that negative 100%. So now there's no fading. It just jumps from word to word. So make the start position 0 and the end position to the end of text. And you can kind of see how this can really be advantageous. I'm going to change this color back to white. So say, what if you had an animation that as you're going through it, you want to highlight each word. If you set these keyframes to hold keyframes, maybe go forward a little bit, and then you can just go through here and jump from one word to the next just by adjusting these start and end percentages. So you have a lot more control over how you want this color applied. And all of these settings apply to your stroke as well. Under advanced tab, you want to set this to ease high 100%, ease low to negative 100%. You're going to control your stroke using the same technique with these percentages. And the color that it's changing to is this green from the color control panel. So see if we make this like a blue, our stroke is this red. As we start to mess with these percentages, it's working directly with our color control panel. Okay, so I'm going to set these back to their defaults and get rid of these keyframes. And I'll say, what if we want this color, say we're going to go just for animator, but we want it to fade in. Well, that's going to be controlled through this option here called amount. Put a keyframe at 100%, move that forward, put this down to 0, and we see it's back to our character panel color. If we watch that, we can see that's how we can fade that in. So you can only imagine all of the times that using a text animator color can benefit you. If you have some text that maybe has a voiceover with it and the client wants to highlight each word, instead of having a few text layers and masking things out and going through a lot of other trouble, you can just use a text animator and bounce through and highlight it as you want to highlight it. The text animator fill and stroke settings are by far the most versatile. You have complete control over the color of your text, how you want it to animate. You can adjust the opacity of the color. You can adjust which character, word, or line that you want to add the color to. See, we already did characters and words. Now look, if we do lines, it's going to jump from one line to the next. You have a lot of control over this. And just remember that text animators work very closely with the character panel color settings. Okay, so just to recap, controlling the color of your text isn't a cut and dry topic. There are essentially four methods you can utilize to control text color, and each one has its strengths and weaknesses, depending on what you want to do. Using the character panel to control your fill and stroke settings is the most common method, and it's possible that that's the only method you've ever used. The character panel allows you to choose different colors for characters, words, and lines, but you can't animate those colors in any way. Using layer styles gives you the ability to animate fills or color overlays and strokes, but you can't choose different colors for characters or words. You can, however, affect the color's opacity, and you have access to blending modes, which can be very useful depending on your needs. You can adjust layer style strokes to 3 settings: inside, outside, and center, all of which affect your stroke differently, much in the same way that fill over stroke or stroke over fill options from the character panel affect your text. Fills, like layer styles, allow you to animate the overall color of your text, but it overrides strokes, and you can't use different colors for characters or words. Don't forget that the opacity setting on fills affect the layer's opacity, not the color's opacity. You also have the option of inverting the fill color so that the background color will be applied to your text and the fill color will be applied to the background. Text Animator fills and strokes are by far the most versatile, giving you complete control over animating text color. You can change the color of a character, word, or line of text, and even animate those colors in any way you'd like. When using Text Animator fills and strokes, don't forget to enable those fills and strokes from the character panel. Otherwise, you won't be able to use the stroke attributes on your text, and you won't be able to see the fill. In order to control stroke over fill or fill over stroke, you must use the character panel settings as there is no setting for this in the Text Animator. You can control the opacity of the color you've chosen by adjusting the amount under the Advanced tab. And you can easily choose if you want to animate the color of characters, words, or lines by adjusting the Based On settings located under the Advanced tab. And remember, fills and layer styles will override Text Animator fills and strokes. To avoid fading colors between characters, lines, and words, set your ease high to 100% and your ease low to negative 100%. Although text animators are by far the most versatile, they do rely on the character panel color control settings in a number of ways. I hope this helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. I'd love to get your feedback about this episode and also hear about any topic you would like to see covered. And don't forget to check out my new Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that literally covers every aspect of shape layers. The link to that course, as well as to the project files and the notes for this episode, are in the description below. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you next time.